आफ्टर द पोर्चुगीज डच फ्रॉम द नेदरलैंड दे अराइव्ड इंडिया एंड दे सेट अप द ट्रेडिंग सेंटर इन इंडिया. एक्चुअली इन द ईयर 1602 द यूनाइटेड ईस्ट इंडिया कंपनी ऑफ द नेदरलैंड वॉज फॉर्म्ड एंड दे गेव द परमिशन फॉर द डच गवर्नमेंट टू ट्रेड इन द ईस्ट इंडीज दैट इज इंडिया जावा सुमात्रा एंड इंडोनेशिया. सो द डच ईस्ट इंडिया कंपनी वॉज एस्टैब्लिश्ड इन द ईयर ओके 1602. सो इन द 1602 डच ईस्ट इंडिया कंपनी was established okay and the Dutch got the permission to trade in the East Indies that is including India, Java, Sumatra and Indonesia and they established a trading center. The first trading center of the Dutch was in Surat. Okay, they first established the trading center in Surat and later on they established the trading center in Broach, okay, Nagapatnam, okay, Masulipatnam, okay, and Cochin. Okay, so in 1602 Dutch East India Company was established. Firstly, they established the trading centers at Surat and later on they established the trading center in the places like Broach, Nagapatnam, Masulipatnam and Cochin. Okay, with this they broke the monopoly of the Portuguese. As I told that Portuguese were the first to come to India and they had a monopoly over the trade. Okay, so the Dutch, they broke this monopoly of the Portuguese in India. Later on, the Dutch grew so powerful in India that they occupied many of the Portuguese possession in India. Okay, further, it is said that they could not stay in India for a long because they have to face a stiff competition with the British and they were not able to compete with the British. Okay, and apart from that, there are several reasons why this Dutch East India Company was not able to be in India. Firstly, it is said that they had a trade interest in the Southeast Asian countries. That is, Southeast Asian countries, that is, includes the Java, Sumatra, Philippines, Malaya. Okay, so the Dutch had the interest in the Southeast Asian countries. So this is one of the reasons why the Dutch were not able to be in India for a longer period. And secondly, the administrative missionaries, that is the administrative missionary of the Dutch was not satisfactory. That is, the workers who are working in the administration, that is in the Dutch government, were not paid proper salaries. That is, they paid a very less salaries. And apart from that, the military system, that is the force that the British, the Dutch they had was not satisfactory. Okay, that it was not well trained. The Dutch who got themselves, that means they were with the many European wars. So what happened? They could not invest much money on the Indian trade. So that is also one of the reasons why the Dutch were not able to continue for a longer period of time. Okay, and later on it is said that the Dutch have to face a stiff competition from the English. And as a result, a number of wars were held. And in that war, it is said that the most of the Dutch ships were sunk by the British. And thus, the trading companies of the Dutch were also captured by the British. So these are the reasons why the Dutch were not able to remain in India as the British were there for such a long time. The third among the Europeans to come to India to trade were the English. So now we'll know about the English. Okay. So the English were the third Europeans to come to India to trade. So like the Portuguese and the Dutch had been earning a huge profit out of the Indian trade. So these British merchants, they also decided to follow these examples. And so they formed a trading company known as the East India Company. And this company has granted permission by Queen Elizabeth. Queen Elizabeth of England, she permitted, I mean, she granted the permission for this East India Company to trade in India. So, in the year 1600, okay, in the 1600, Queen Elizabeth, okay, Queen Elizabeth granted permission to the East India Company to trade in India. Okay. So in 1600, Queen Elizabeth granted permission for the East India Company to trade in India. So later on, the Mughal emperor, okay, they issued a royal permission to this English to set up their factory at Surat. So like this, this first English merchant ship reached Surat. Okay, and Surat, as you all know, it is one of the prosperous port and also a major city. Okay, so later on, Sir Thomas Roy, okay, the ambassador in the court of the James I, he visited to the Mughal court, that is the court of Jahangir, and requested to permit them to establish a trading center in India. So later on, Emperor Jahangir, he allowed, that is, to the British to build up their colonies and the trade centers at Surat, Agra, Ahmedabad and Brooch. Okay, so the British established the trading centers at Agra, okay, Ahmedabad, okay, Surat and Brooch. So Jahangir granted permission for these Britishers to establish the trading centers in these places. And these Britishers, that is the English, when they come, they had brought with them the woolen clothes, tin, iron to trade for, that means to trade with the Indians. And in return, they purchased the Indian goods like silk, cotton, textiles, spices, etc. So soon, these Britishers, they built their settlement even in the other places like in Madras, Bombay and Calcutta also, and enlarged their commercial activities. It is said that in the beginning, that is these three places, that is Madras, Bombay and Calcutta, were very small villages in those days. Okay, and it is also said that actually the Bombay, okay, it was received from the Portuguese by an English officer, okay, and later on he gave it to the company on a lease for the annual, that means for the £10 per annum. Okay. So like this, formerly Bombay was a small village. Later on it developed into a city under the able administrator called as Governor Gerard. Okay, Governor Gerard had played a very important role in developing this Bombay as one of the important city and major city. Later on, it is said that during the first four decades of the 18th century, this East India Company, the trading activities and influence began to grow and grow so fast that it began to earn enormous profit. Okay, the company made an enormous profit. And later on, this East India Company, they demanded, that is the Indian rulers, that they should be permitted to trade without tax. That is, usually you know that when you have a trade or a business, you need to pay a certain amount to the government in the form of a tax. And that is a source of revenue to the government. So initially these people, that is the British, were paying a partial amount of their income, in their income as a tax to the government, that is to the Mughal government. But later on, as they grew powerful, they demanded the Mughal rulers that to allow them to trade in India without paying the taxes, that is free of duties. Okay, so like this, they obtained dastaks. Dastaks means it is a free pass that was given to the British traders in India to trade in, okay, in the Bengal provinces. So like this, the Mughal ruler, who was weak, that is Farukh Siyar, who was a weak ruler at that time, he permitted the English, that means he granted the English this dastaks. Okay, and they gave, and he gave the right to trade in Bengal provinces. And at that time, the Bengal Bengal province was an extensive territory. That means it included the present Bihar and Orissa. It was a vast territory. It was a big territory, okay, which include even present Bihar and Orissa. So they traded there. The British, without paying the tax, with this license, they traded there, okay, and thus they enjoyed more privileges than the Indian and other European merchants, okay. So like this, consequently, that is slowly this Britishers emerged as a powerful ruler in India. And in order to improve their situation, that means in order to strengthen their position in India, these Britishers, what did they do? They had built a fort in their settlements, that is in their residential areas. They built a strong fort around the settlement, and along with that, they also had employed, that means appointed a few guards also as a soldier, that means few guards to protect their residential areas. And they also had guns and other arteries also with them. So like this, within a short period of time, these Britishers who had come to India as a traders, they began to become more powerful with the military power than the other Indian rulers. So the last among the Europeans who come to India to trade were the French. So the French were the last Europeans to come to India to trade in India. And it was in the year 1664. In the year 1664, Colbert, minister of Louis XIV, he established the French East India Company. Okay. And this company established their first trading center at Surat. And later on, they colonized. That means they established the trading centers at a place called as Pondicherry, Machilipatnam, Chandranagore, Mahe, Karaikal, etc. So, in the year, it is said that in the year 1674, these French people, they obtained a small village called as a Vali Kandapuram, okay, which it is from the Muslim ruler, that is the Sultan of Bijapur. And later on, they had developed this village into such a way that it has become one of the prosperous city, okay, and it is known as a Pondicherry. And Pondicherry, later on, it became one of the headquarters of the French power in India. Okay. And later on, in 1764, the Dupley, the governor of India, that is, came to India as a governor of Pondicherry. And he led he had a high ambition of establishing the French power in India. That is, he wanted to establish French as a major power in South India. But the English had already had become powerful, and they have established a supremacy over the South. So like this, many battles were fought between the English and the French. And these battles are known as the Carnatic War. And Dupley, who had wished to establish this power in India, that is, he had also had played a very important in strengthening the French power in India by playing an important role in the politics of the Tamil Nadu. That is, his influence were found in the Carnatic War with the clash between the local rulers in the Tamil Nadu. Okay, so later on it is said that they lost. That means these wars have brought a great downfall to the French and ascended. That means the British established their power. That means they established their supremacy in India. Now we'll know the causes for the decline of the French power in India. Firstly, political confusion and revolution took place in France. It means that, as you all know, the French East India Company is a private company and it was a part of the government, and as the government intervention was involved in it, you could see the government intervening in all the matters of the East India Company. So it faced a lot of problem. Okay, it has to face a lot of government intervention. And even the financial position of the French company was not very strong. And the French government had paid no attention. That means they did not pay due attention to these problems of the company. So that is first one of the reason. Okay. So French East India Company, part of the government. And you could see a lot of intervention of the French government in it. And it has to face a lot of government intervention. And even the financial condition was also not strong. And the French government did not pay any attention to these problems of the company. Secondly, in those days, that is when the French and the English power was there in India, there was a war. That means the Anglo-French war was held, and I told you it is a Carnatic war. When the war was going on in India, even in Europe, there was a conflict between the England and France. Okay, the conflict was arose even in England and France in Europe. Okay, and the French government was not only trying to settle this problem over the Europe, but also wanted to occupy America. Government was not only trying to settle its control over the Europe, but also wanted to control on the America. So like this, the British politicians involved, that means these Britishers have involved France in all the European war, so much that they made the French not find time to pay the attention on the wars in India. Okay, I think you all understood, like how the French and English war was going on in India. Similarly, there was a conflict between the French and the English in Europe. And further, these French were also trying to establish their hold on America. So in this war, the British engaged the French in such a way that they made the French to forget completely about the wars in India. So that is also one of the reason for the failure. That means they failed to establish their power and lose their power in India. So having been defeated, that means the French was defeated in the Europe war. So having been defeated in Europe, these French, they failed to face the English in India. Okay. And the next reason is, on the other hand, these French paid no attention to the naval forces, that is the navy. They paid least attention on the navy. Okay. So they did not concentrate, and even the governor of Dupley, okay, he did not care much to the naval development, that is the navy. Consequently, what happened? The control of the France on the sea was loosened. And it is said that Dupley was able to be successful as a governor in India as long as the British did not make use of this navy. Okay. After this, the French failed to establish, that means they were able to achieve any success. I think you all understood. Okay. The French did not pay attention to the navy. Okay. Dupley, he did not concentrate, that means pay less importance, that means did not care and did not give much importance to the development of navy. Okay. And he was successful only because the Britishers did not use the navy, and after that, that means when they started using, he did not be able to successful that as a governor. The last reason for the French to decline in India is that the French officers and the officials were not united. You could see the lot of differences were found between them, and it did not allow them to do anything unitedly. So these differences is one of the reason for the downfall. And there was also no harmony among these officials, those who are working in the office also. Sometimes you could see these officials of the French company disobeying the orders of the officers. So all these reasons weaken the French power in India.